anytime you're dealing with a wild animal, no matter how big or small, there's always a level of danger. But when you're dealing with a bear and you're going in and waking it up and diving headfirst into its house, you know, the danger's a little bit elevated. Let's go find a bear.
Defoe locates a bear that gave birth to two cubs the previous spring and directs the biologist to the area. The team will then use their antenna to pinpoint the exact location of the bear's den.
2.5.
Once they locate the den, the biologists will tranquilize all of the bears they find so that they can weigh them and place an ID tag on the yearling cubs for future tracking of the bear population.
See the muddy footprints here? You can see the mother's track and the yearling's track. The small one and the big one.
The tranquilizer that the biologists use is a hallucinogen and takes at least 10 minutes to work on a full-grown bear.
Whenever you encounter a bear in the wild, the first thing it wants to do is get away from you. But in this instance, we're not giving it that chance. We want to surround it. We want to kind of pin it down.
Humans are no match for a full-grown black bear. They can weigh as much as 600 pounds and run at speeds of up to 35 miles per hour.
Bears are an extremely strong animal. They're like a giant muscle tied together with bones. And in the right situation, that can make them a very deadly animal to deal with.
The signal leads to a hollow under a tree where there appears to be a den. Biologist Lisa Bates sees only one sleeping bear inside, so she reaches in with a tranquilizer syringe to inject it.
It's a cornered, frightened bear. I mean, you really don't want to mess with it too much, but with these guys, they know what they're doing.
He's not going anywhere now.
There's no sign of the mother in the den, so the team needs to be on the lookout for her in case she returns.
I'm gonna pass it to you and you can put him on the sleeping bag.
Yep.
Just grab him by the scruff of the neck like you would your puppy.
Come on, buddy.
Put him around the bag.
Perfect. They shed their foot pads every year. We take that as a DNA sample.
There's one.
He's got a nice, beautiful, fluffy coat.
Curtis spots another bear nearby.
You see her?
The tranquilizer dart hits its target, but the biologists can't let the bear get away before it's knocked out. It's another cub.
Pretty exciting.
Which means that the mother bear is still out there somewhere.